What's his name?
Alan. Alan Matthew Hart.
How do I know that you won't abandon him again?
Well, I didn't really abandon him this time, not totally. I was all set to go right back and take him when I saw him in your arms, and I... something hit me. That he was better off. But, I can't go on living without my son, Miss Vassal. And, I'm getting help for my depression problems. I'm so sorry for causing you this hurt.
Imagine a device that would warn.
Call me.
A baby story coming up next on TLC Daytime.
Come here, honey. I got an idea for this Texas flag.
Lisa and Joe Fratangelo are Texans who will soon be welcoming a cowgirl into their family. Joe is hoping to find the perfect diaper bag.
Is this me or what?
And their friends are throwing a shower they'll never forget.
Mark, get set, go!
Now Joe and Lisa feel ready to say howdy to their firstborn.
Good push, come on.
Good job.
Keep that baby out there.
Okay.
Go. Okay, I got the base put in my truck for the car seat, and then I'll put one in your truck too. But basically,
we met on a blind date. We were set up by his roommate and my roommate to go to a sorority formal, and we didn't like each other that much
that first night.
He wasn't my type. I wasn't his type, and we just kind of parted ways that night. And I thought that was it. But then he came back and he called me.
I was worried that people on campus would find out what a bad date I was and it would ruin my reputation. So I had to call her back to, you know, make up for it, just take her out to a nice dinner. She accepted, and on the second date, we really got to know each other a lot better because we weren't in that party atmosphere. And we just had a wonderful time and fell in love, and that's been 12 years.
When we first got married, we said we always knew we wanted kids, and at first we said we'd like to stay married 2 or 3 years to get to know each other really well and to have some time to be with ourselves. And then 2 or 3 years went by, and we said, well, maybe we'll wait 5 years. And 5 years comes and goes, and we said, okay, well, maybe a couple more years. We just were enjoying our time together, and weren't ready to bring someone else into this mix. And then finally, after 10 years, we said, okay, we're ready. A couple mornings I woke up and I was nauseous and I was like, there's just no way, there's no way. And I even told him, I said, Joe, you know, I'm nauseous, I might be pregnant. He's like, no, you know, we just start trying that. And so one day, this was around Christmas time, on the way home from work, I stopped and got a pregnancy test, came home and Joe was still at work. And so I took it all by myself, thinking there's no way. Just, and then all of a sudden, you know, 3 minutes later, I come back into the bathroom and there's the big plus. And I was going, oh, no way, there's no way, there's no way.
I came home from work on Christmas Eve, and I usually don't get home till close to midnight. And she's waiting up for me, and she insists on opening a present on Christmas Eve, which it's not one of my traditions, but she insisted on doing that, and we didn't buy a lot of presents for each other, so this is just one less, because we've been spending all our money on the house. It's one less present we're going to have. So she gives me this little box, and it's a Victoria's Secret box. I'm thinking, what kind of gift is this? And she says, that's the only box I could find. Well, I open up the box, and inside is the tester, the pregnancy tester. And my head just immediately starts spinning. I go into vapor lock, and I'm like, what is this? And she's, we're pregnant. It took a little while for it to settle in. And then as it started to settle in, and I thought about it, and I just started thinking about my future and what I'm going to be doing with my baby and watching her grow up. And I just can't wait to, when she gets to that age where when I come in the door at night and she's like, Daddy, you're home, and runs up to me.
Let's compare these baby pictures to our ultrasound and see who she's going to look like.
We had an ultrasound and the technician said, do you want to know the sex? We said yes. And so she says, it's a girl. And we were all excited. We started clapping and we're just really excited.
Well, as a police officer, being a potential father or future father has definitely had an impact on my job. The minute I found out that Lisa was pregnant, it changed my whole outlook on the job, and I became a lot more careful because now I've got a child coming that's going to be dependent on me, and I don't want her to have to grow up without a father. So I you know, always make sure that I wear my vest and I take my officer safety tactics a lot more seriously now than I did in the past.
I still like Sophie.
I like Marissa. Maybe we can decide.
We can flip a coin.
My vote is for Sophie.
And my vote is for Marissa. And
I think
we don't
she's
know
winning.
Who.
Every time I write a letter to somebody, we have, I sign it Joe and Lisa, and then I put in parentheses, and Marissa/Sophie with a question mark.
People always vote for Marissa.
We had a second ultrasound done on video. The technician zeroed in on her, there's a little face.
Oh, wow. And
she was looking at me and looking at the screen. She goes, she's got daddy's lips and nose. And I'm like, where did you see that?
Didn't she wink at us one time?
Oh, when we went back and we reviewed we sat down there for hours watching the video, going frame by frame by frame. I go, did you see that? She blinked at us. She blinked because she's like, we can write at the camera or whatever. And I just can't wait for her to get out here so we can actually see what she looks like.
Okay. We can just carry him like, carry her like this.
Okay, that's why we go to parenting classes, so we can practice stuff like this.
You just dropped the baby.
Oh, the baby. Well, no, she's strapped in there, so she's not going any place.
Okay, I think we need more practice.
It's okay, it's okay.
TLC ends the year with a look to our future. Be there at the start of a new generation. A Baby Story New Year, Friday, noon to 5, on TLC Daytime.
Elmo is landing on video. Now you can own the fun, most excellent adventure.
Go, Elmo!
The Adventures of Elmo in Grouchland. Buy it now on video and DVD.
George.
Wow.
We've always captured your imagination.
Holy Toledo.
Now we're doing it online.
Holy Toledo.
Now there's Sears.com, 2,000 appliances, the top six brands, guaranteed low prices. And right now, your chance to win a Kenmore Elite Dream Kitchen. Holy Toledo, Sears.com.
Today we're here at the Bellini store and we're gonna look at some dad gear, which includes some diaper bag and other items that dad can carry so Joe doesn't have to carry any pink diaper bags.
Hi, this is Perry. He's the designer and creator of Dad's
Hi.
Gear.
Hi.
I'm gonna let him explain everything to you and go from there.
Great.
How you doing, Perry?
Hi.
Nice to meet you. I'm Joe.
Hi, Joe.
Lisa.
Hi. How are you?
I heard some good things about your products.
Well, great. You've come to the right place. Let me show you the products.
Okay.
I designed these products because there's just not enough stuff for men out there. I found products that were unisex that my wife or I could carry, but it didn't have the features that I was looking for. Mainly organization. Well, yeah. See, a lot of stuff for women. Everything is for women out there, pretty much.
Not exactly something to my speed.
I don't think so.
The designer is showing us his line of dad gear, and you can tell immediately that it doesn't look like the traditional diaper bags and carry-alls.
Very nice.
Okay, this is the Nico bag. This is our top-of-the-line model and our first model. In the front, I made this compartment for Dad because he's going to be carrying this thing around. I was losing my keys a lot of the times. I'd set them down and walk away.
You have too many keys.
Exactly. I have a lot of keys.
So
I put this in there. You hook them on there. They're always here where you can find them. I put my pager and my cell phone in here, and you won't lose them that way. Behind that is the main compartment of this bag, and that's called the changing station. Completely organized section. You can see through the mesh pockets what you have. Behind the changing station is more storage space. Back here, you can put extra clothes. You're going to need a lot of clothes. You're going to need toys. And behind that is where your changing pad will go, in this compartment here.
Let me try that thing out.
Sure, sure. Let's get it on you there. There you go.
There we go.
You can loosen them right there. There you go.
Ah, oh, very nice.
I'd feel a lot more comfortable carrying one of these bags around with my daughter than one of the more traditional knapsacks.
Well, thank you, Perry, for taking the time to show us your product line.
My pleasure.
Excellent product, well thought out. It's about time somebody thought of something like this for us dads.
Definitely. We're past due on having some gear for men. So
I'll have to drop a hint to my coworkers to pick me up one of these before the baby's born.
Good idea. Good idea.
Thank you again.
Okay. Thank you.
Today we're having a baby shower at our house, and it's going to be a lot of fun. It's really nice to have all our friends here, since we don't have any relatives. They're like a second family to us, and it's a good feeling to know that we have so many people that care about us.
Go see the cake. The cake's over here. It's awesome.
To be a child of Joe and Lisa, she's going to be brilliant, she's going to be beautiful, she's going to have class, grace, they're going to be the best parents, and I'm so glad that they're including me in her life. I can't wait, I'm so excited.
So we call her Daniela?
Ooh, there you go.
Back here we have an easel set up with a blow-up of the ultrasound, and we've set this up so that our guests can assist us in choosing of a name and make little statements to the baby that we can put in her baby book and show her when she grows up.
No, you have to drink it from the nipple. Who can drink it the fastest from the nipple?
Uh-huh.
And y'all are on a team. Y'all seven guys, you have to root for each other, okay?
Remember how.
Okay?
Right, exactly.
Ready?
Hey, somebody say go.
Ready?
Cheers.
Mark, get set.
Win, we get a beer.
Go. No cheating. What's cheating? You can't open it.
Both very active, both very mature.
I think they're going to be, or that's going to enable them to better guide their child and subsequent children in the right direction. And I think most of us always thought they would make wonderful parents.
Here, Jill, you're going to have to taste and guess.
Ready?
Yeah.
Go. Open your mouth.
What flavor is it?
Hey, you can close the diaper back up now.
Donna.
What is it, Joe?
What is it?
Carrots.
Okay, wait. Let's wait and see. Ben, what is it?
It's got to be sweet potatoes or something like that. Okay, what was it?
Nobody got this one right.
What was it?
Potatoes and green beans. It's just so strange to see all these people here that have had babies that I've seen, been to their showers, and now it's all for me. It's just, it feels really strange and wonderful at the same time.
Okay, we just want to say thanks to everybody for coming to our shower today. We're really glad everybody traveled so far. Some people driving an hour or 2 hours to get here and spend this day with us.
We really appreciate it because, you know, since we're alone out here from Texas, all y'all are like our second Aww. Family. And we really mean that.
Hi, sis. Sorry, I'm late.
Long line at the pharmacy?
No, I had to stop at the cash machine.
You just stopped for cash before the drugstore.
I had to stop again after this prescription. $63?
It's time you started carrying this card.
People's prescription plan?
This card will get you the best price for your prescription.
Yeah, but don't you get it through Bob's company?
We couldn't afford his company plan. We saw this on TV, and it costs less than $8 a month.
Per person?
Per household. One membership covers me, Bob, even Mom, because she lives with us.
That's right. Medicare doesn't cover her medications.
Now she gets the best price at the pharmacy, too. We all do.
Okay, ladies, what can I get you?
I'll take one people's prescription plan to go. Oh, and my sister here is treating.
Why me?
For waiting so long to tell me about the People's Prescription Plan.
This card has saved Americans over $100 million on prescriptions. If you don't have a drug plan, either at work or through Medicare, join the People's Prescription Plan and get in on the savings. Just $7.95 a month guarantees you and every member of your household the plan's lowest available price on all types of prescriptions. New prescriptions, refills, injectables, and more. Plus, save up to half off the cost of eyeglasses and contact lenses. Save even more on hearing aids, vitamins, even health equipment. Just show your card at any one of thousands of pharmacies nationwide. There are no claim forms, and you can use your card again and again, so there's no limit to how much you can save. Don't you deserve to get the best price on your prescriptions? Join today.
Hi.
Hey, sis.
I really did save with the People's Prescription Plan.
Great. Today lunch is on you.
Call 1-800-426-3200 to join the People's Prescription Plan. Have your credit card ready or send check or money order to People's Prescription Plan, P.O. Box 1340, Valley Forge, Pennsylvania, 19482. You have nothing to lose with our 60-day money-back guarantee. That number again is 1-800-426-3200. Call now.
Next on TLC Daytime.
It's a boy.
Where do babies come from? Here are people who've learned the answer firsthand. Love is the key to it all. More of a baby story coming up on TLC Daytime.
More Balmex. Do you guys know something I don't?
Balmex really clears up diaper rash
and wipes off easily
without irritating baby's skin.
Thanks, guys.
Balmex.
The future is
coming. Guess what? I think we're going to Walt Disney World. Mom and Dad are watching that video again of all that fun stuff about the millennium.
It's millennial.
To make this a magical year your family will always remember, call 1-800-672-9474 for your free Walt Disney World vacation planning video. You'll see all the spectacular sights and sounds planned for our year-long millennium celebration.
A millennium is like a whole 1,000 years.
Is that as old as Grandpa?
The video shows you how to stay at a Disney resort for as low as $74 a night, and how the magic can take you to sea by combining your celebration with a relaxing Disney cruise to the Bahamas. For your free video, hurry and call 1-800-672-9474 today.
Wow. Can we stay for the whole millennium?
Celebrate the future.
Oh.
Well, today's a big day. We arrived early this morning for a scheduled inducement. We've been here several hours, and things are progressing kind of slowly. Active labor hasn't started yet, but we're all really excited and looking forward to seeing our new daughter. We haven't decided on a name yet.
He almost wore a Texas pin today.
I wanted to wear a Texas pin on my
shirt. So she could be born under the Texas flag.
I'm really, really anxious. I'm feeling okay right now. Contractions aren't that hard. My sister came in from Florida, and she's had two babies. She's had a C-section and a natural birth, and so she knows how it is for both, so she can support me also.
You just talked through a contraction and didn't tell us?
That's what they were doing.
I was breathing slow.
This cockiness is going to end soon.
We're off to a fairly slow start. She came in this morning. We started the Pitocin on her. Doctor came 8:30, broke her water, which usually helps speed up the labor. We're in a nice contraction pattern, but she's still smiling. So we have to wipe the smile off her face. So we're just going up on the Pitocin and hoping the smile disappears soon.
Let's just turn you up a bit more. Okay, too much smiling. You're supposed to be in labor, pain.
The highest is 46, she said?
The highest 46, we're almost there. Otherwise, we start going back down again because you've got too much Pitocin on board. So are you feeling anything? Mm-hmm. Are they getting stronger? Mm-hmm. You're still smiling.
I'm smiling.
You're smiling. Okay, well, could you just stop smiling in between the contractions? Smile in between, but not with. Okay, I'll be back. Call me if you need me.
So we're now entering hour number 9. Not making much progress. Lisa's only dilated 1 centimeter, but she's in a little discomfort. So the doctor's giving her some medication to help her relax and maybe get a little bit of shut eye.
I don't want to be asleep when this baby comes.
I just have a feeling she's going to look like a Sophie. I don't know, but I always liked Marissa.
What does a Sophie look like?
I don't know. I just have this picture in my head.
Okay, your cervix is almost completely effaced, so it's completely thin.
Oh, good, Lisa.
And you're about 3 centimeters, so right. Good job.
Lisa.
So now we're going to put her epidural in, so she'll get total pain relief and hopefully progress more. We're hoping that she'll deliver before I get home. That's another few hours.
I heard you got your epidural.
Mm-hmm.
Good. Is that better?
Mm-hmm. A lot.
Are you feeling anything with them now?
Mm-mm.
Woohoo! Lisa's happy.
Success!
Yeah, right. The next exam, we're going to try again to put that monitor on the baby's head. We're losing the baby on some of the monitoring. And that's okay, but we'd like to keep a little bit close. Looks like there's a cord probably somewhere that is grabbing or around his neck.
Okay. Well, or a purse.
That's good. So that's really common, but you know, as long as the baby looks fine, don't worry about it.
Okay. All righty. We had a little doctor visit, so we got to log that in the book. I've been keeping a log of the events of the day, recording everything that goes on minute by minute as her condition progresses and as people come to visit. And I think this will be a great memento for my daughter when she grows up.
Okay. All right. I'm just checking that little bit of cervix that's there. When you have a contraction, the baby gets pushed down enough that I can just move it over the baby's head. So what we're going to do is get you ready to start pushing. Now is the time. No going back. And this baby has a ton of hair.
Oh my gosh.
So do you normally have a ton of hair, Dad?
Yeah.
Okay, he shaves his head every day. Can you tell if it's curly yet?
No, not yet. I can't tell you what color it is because it's all wet right now anyway. But it looks dark. Once we get the baby out and dry it off a bit.
It has to be curly, Joe. I promised him if it was curly hair, it should be Sophie.
Oh!
Ready?
Get ready.
Push down.
One, two,
push down.
Three, four,
curl
five,
around, baby. Curl
six,
around.
Seven, eight,
that's it.
Nine, ten.
Bear down.
Down to the bottom.
Push down. Come on, Lisa. You've got it. Come on, bit more.
Good.
Good.
She's
running out
of energy.
Yeah. Okay, take a deep breath. Push again. Down into your bottom.
Push,
go on. Keep it going. Come on.
Lots of pressure.
Come on, Lisa, you can do it.
Good.
Okay. Excellent.
Good. I think your very best if we do something to help this baby out.
So we're going to be doing a vacuum.
It's going to take more than one.
They need to be ready to come in a couple of minutes.
Get the baby out. Even when I'm cooling with the vacuum, I can only exert so much force, and so you need to be pushing with all
on the other end.
Use that, because all I'm doing is just keeping it kind of where you push it. I'm not pulling it out, and it doesn't work that way.
Are you pushing?
Push down.
Go on then.
Come on.
Keep it coming. Keep it coming. Keep it coming. Oh. Keep it coming. Good job, Lisa. Come on. A lot of pressure.
Push, baby. Come on, baby. Push it.
Come on.
Push, baby. Come on, babe.
You can do it. Almost done.
Almost done.
Come on, come on.
And again, come on, Lisa. You can do this. You can.
No, you got to, honey. You got to. Let's go. Push. Bear down.
That's it. Come on. Okay. Relax.
Okay.
As the
baby
comes out, the pressure stops,
Lee.
Yes, it will.
Yes, it will, honey.
Believe us.
Coming.
We can see it.
Take a good rest.
I can see the top of her head. She's right there.
Push down again. Come on. You can do it.
Push, Lisa.
Push down,
come on, honey.
Push down. That's it. And again. Come on.
Come on, baby.
You've got it, honey. You've got it. Come on. That's it. Okay. Stop. Low. Low.
It's okay, you're almost done, baby.
Oh, there's the problem there. The little cord here.
Oh, and the cord. Is the hand up? That's it. Okay.
Here she comes.
Look down, Lisa. Look down. Oh. Look at that. She was wrapped in her cord. 803. Hi. Say hello. Hello. Happy birthday. Yeah. Okay, let's get some of this out. Yeah, I know. Good job.
So great.
Yes, you're a cute baby. Yes, you are. Cute baby. Look at that face. Here you go. Is she pretty? I love you, baby.
If you're pregnant, live in the Los Angeles area, and are interested in being on A Baby Story, call 323-851-2333 or email babystory@pietownprods.com. Couples must live in the LA area so that the crew can arrive to capture the birth.
When you can look but not touch.
I wish I could live Dickie's life.
Anything can happen. Matt Damon, Gwyneth Paltrow, Jude Law, the talented Mr. Ripley, rated R. Now playing everywhere.
Hello, this is Mark John Jeffries for PPPC. A friend just emailed me that there was a grave oversight in my last chat with you. Well, I told you how you could get a really terrific brand name PC, like this one. Plus, unlimited internet access, in-home service, and great deals, all for just $24.95 a month. I did not say out loud how easy it is to get in touch with PPPC, but I could fix that right now. Visit us at peoplepc.com or just dial 1-800-PEOPLE-PC. Simple. While you get something to write with, let me go over the plan one more time. Let's review. For about the price of internet service alone, you get the whole pie over here. A new computer, in-home service, deals, and unlimited internet access. Visit us at peoplepc.com or call us. Thank you for letting me set the record straight.
Now. It's the the chances you get to be a real doctor. You take care of a child just because the child needs you, and you got the skills to take care of the child, and that's all there is to it.
Real doctors, real stories, real life. The new 24-hour Discovery Health Channel. To get it, contact your local cable company or DirecTV.
Hi there. Do you want to talk about our first trip to Texas? Huh? Are you going to go with Daddy in the truck or Mommy on the airplane?
After she was born, we had a lot of difficulty deciding on what name to choose. So it finally came down to a coin flip. I flipped the coin, and it goes up and lands on the bed. And right as it lands on the bed, she yells out, "Tails!" And I go, "No, I
didn't see it."
You can't do that. You've got to let the, you got to call it in the air. So, and it landed on tails. So
I won.
I reflipped, first time I won. And it came up heads. So I said, "Okay, I win." Sophie, about 20 minutes goes by, and she starts sniffling. "I can't do it. I don't want to name her Sophie." And I'm like, "Okay, all right, whatever you want to do, that's fine with me." If she wanted to go ahead and break our binding decision with no regrets to go ahead and, you know, name her whatever she wanted.
So then I was like, "Okay, she has the dark hair, but it's not curly, and she sort of looks like a Sophie, and she really looks like her daddy." And so I said, "Okay, Sophie's it." My favorite time with Sophie is when I'm feeding her. I can feel her body kind of go warm and fuzzy when we're together like that. She knows I'm her mama and that I'm gonna take care of her. And it's just like, it's a really special time that we have. My sweet Sophie.
This baby has changed her life for the better in many ways. And it's just this warm feeling that I never had experienced before. And we just can't believe that this baby is ours and our responsibility to raise and love and watch her grow, and it's pretty exciting.
She suffers from hearing loss and relies on reading lips, but babies can't always tell you what they need, so a specially trained dog will let her know when the baby cries on A Baby Story, next. And go to TLC.com for baby safety tips. Baby Story, coming up next on TLC Daytime.
Victor and Allison Sepulveda, both 29, have been married for 2 years and are expecting their first child. Allison suffers from profound hearing loss and relies on hearing aids and reading lips.